Hello and welcome to the show. So Need for Speed Most Wanted only features 41 cars, which doesn't really sound a lot when you say it, but the cars are fairly well varied. They feature the sort of standard ones, the sort that you see in all racing games, like this M3 here, there's 911s, and Lamborghini Gallardos, but what are the more interesting cars featured on the game? I've brought Daniel along to have a look at some of them. So,
hi guys.
First up, we have the Tesla Roadster. Now, this does feature on some other games, but I thought I'd put this one in here because, well, it's an electric car, and it's probably the only cool electric car there's ever been. I'm kind of messing about here in some underground area, and it's pretty damn good at doing sort of drifts. Okay, every car, Need for Speed is, but it's good to see an electric car sort of represented in less serious games.
Yeah, I think, I mean, obviously it features in Forza and stuff, but this is this is the first time I've seen the Tesla in any other game bar Forza. You know, like sort of more arcadey side.
I think it is, yeah. And it's not even a bad car to drive. Okay, it's not particularly fast in a straight line. I think it maxes out about 120. But yeah, it's good to see an electric car or electric cars being represented in different games, and a good electric car at that, not some silly Nissan Leaf.
So yeah, I mean, really good game. Graphics look in detail and looks really good on it. So.
Yeah. Now, in typical Burnout tradition, there is normally a Formula One car in the game, but of course, because all the cars are licensed in this game, there's no Formula One, but there is this, the BAC Mono. Now, this is the only game I've seen this car in outside of Project Cars, I think it's in. And, well, it's a track car, it's brilliantly good handling, good brakes as well as I slow down for a police car. Looks bizarre, but kind of cool at the same time. And
sort of
it's
Caparo T1
fast.
Sort of styling you can see there.
Yeah, yeah, it's very reminiscent of a Caparo. Again, it doesn't have a particularly high top speed. I think it's only about 150 because it's a sort of track car and designed for grip. But yeah, the grip's phenomenal. Don't have a battle with an Aero Latin V8, by the way. You kind of lose on that one. But
yeah, that's not going to work. No, again,
it's a great car to drive.
Yeah, it's just, again, it's nice to see Need for Speed have taken the more sort of track-based cars and put them into more of an arcadey environment. It's just good the way they, you know, it's good the way they thought of that, which is, it's just a good selling point for the game.
Yeah, and it's something different to drive. Now, next up, we have the Subaru Impreza Cosworth. Now, you put Cosworth in any car, and the chances are it's going to be very, very good. And there's no exception here. This is a brilliant four-wheel drive car, one of the best sort of off-road cars, I guess you could say, in this game. There are some kind of rallycross events, but there's some off-road driving, and yeah, I really, really like this car. It sounds brilliant. It's got a lovely little turbo whistle that you can kind of hear in the background. Yeah, it's a great car.
It's just nice to see. I know I keep saying it, but it's good to see that the new Need for Speed game, they thought of everything. They thought of what they can do with everything.
Something different.
Gerald, like, as you can see here. Yeah.
It's just good to see what they can think of. Yeah, it's good to see some different cars being given a chance in games rather than all the sort of regulars. There are, of course, the regulars in there. There's an Evo 10, sort of standard stuff, but it's nice to see something different. Next up, we have the Marussia B2. Now, most of us will know Marussia as a not particularly fast Formula One team, but until this game, I never knew they actually made a road car. This is it. It's kind of a cross between a Devon GTX and a Toyota Manta, I think. It looks interesting.
Striking.
It's not a sort of normal style. Yeah, it's not a sort of normal styled car. And again, I've never seen this on another game. And it's pretty damn quick. I mean, top speed is looking in the 180s and something. Handling's pretty good. Although, of course, most cars handle pretty well on here. But it's got quite a lot of grip. It's quite a good sounding car as well through this tunnel.
So, yeah, I mean, you know, it's just, it's odd. It's odd. I mean, you know, it's got the BAC Mono in, but it's also got something else that is genuinely sort of, I never knew they made it. So there's lots of sort of odd cars that you wouldn't normally see.
And the final car we have here is the Aerial Atom V8. Now, this is another sort of track-based car that hasn't been in very many games. I think Test Drive 2 is the only game.
Yeah, Test Drive was the last one that featured in.
But again, it's something, well, in this case, it's incredible acceleration. Probably the fastest of all the cars in the game. Really, really good handling. Drifts really well. Yeah, it's probably my favourite car to drive at the moment. It's just ridiculous amounts of grip. It's so easy to sort of get in and out. Real life is a bonkers car, and here it's even more. You can just dive in and out of traffic. Very easy to avoid stuff with it as well.
Yeah, I think, it's just what Need for Speed have done, where they've taken more track-based cars and then put them into a different environment which you wouldn't normally see, which gives it a bit more of a fun factor, I think.
Yeah, and because of the Machinima grip, they're very easy to sort of throw about, and they make for great racing. Now, of course, horsepower figures and all of that stuff is pretty much useless in this game, because all the cars are, you can race pretty much anything against anything. But there's loads of cool cars in this game, so that's about it really for this video. So we hope you enjoyed it, and you should definitely go check it out when Need for Speed comes out. I think it's 2nd of November is the release date, if I remember rightly. But yeah,
think so.
So thank you very much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.